service. Hello. What are you doing? Ah, 성경학교 이렇게 끝나. 아, 성경학교구나. 우리가 성경학교에 앉아. 성경학교 여기 이렇게 들어가네.
The kids that brought in coins, they brought it and put it into their jug, their color jug, and coins increased their total. And if they brought in paper bills, they would put it into another group's jug because that decreased their total. Does that make sense? So, coins increase, paper money decreases. And so, throughout the week, we collected, and George and Jim have the first slide, we collected combined 1,156 nickels, 7,623 pennies, and even 5 silver dollars. In addition to that, our kids were really generous. They brought in coins from Italy, England, Canada, New Zealand, Argentina. They brought in some euros, Cayman Islands, Brazil, and the Philippines. We are truly a global church. If we can go to the next slide. We'll give you a preschool this week. They brought in $91.64. And Kathy's and Pastor Bianca over there, our preschool leader. Unfortunately, other groups put $43 in bills in there. So their net total is $48.64. But their actual total in real dollars was $134.64. So let's give our preschoolers a hand. And I'm going to say that each mani drop lasts for 6 months and it's only $5. So our preschoolers did really well together. We're going to invite Ms. Claudette back up and we're going to sing some more songs and then we have another friend to introduce to you.
The many, many ways that Jesus rescues us, that we have so, so many reasons to be thankful that Jesus is who he is, and that we are who we are, and that he wants to be our best friend. And so we've been singing a song all week long that names just a few of the very many reasons we have to be thankful to Jesus. The song is called Million Reasons. And again, I want to invite all the VBS kids to stand up. If you want to sing from where you are, you can do that. If you want to come down front and stand on the carpet here in front of the steps, you can do that. But let's do Million Reasons. And remember, I go first and you echo. Here we go.
shipwreck
not
on.
Worry. When our lives are in His hands and everything about our lives is in His hands, we won't have to worry about a thing. So that's going to be our last song this morning. Sing with us.
Oh, that just always so much fun to watch.
It is always fantastic to be able to. Oh, hip hop. Well, let's try that one more time then. He said, good morning. How are you doing? No. He walked out and he saw our stuffed animal and he kicked her stuffed animal. And then she started crying and he walked away and didn't comfort her at all. And then his mom asked him to take out the trash and he just started complaining about all the hard work he has to do. And he was just not a happy young man. But you know what? He was sitting there and suddenly he realized, I really shouldn't be doing this because that's not the way God designed me to be. God designed me to be a caring person. A person who watches out for all the people around me. A person who watches out for my world around me and cares for it. And a person who is always looking for what God's will is. What, how God can live in his life. So I think that's the way we want to be. Billy made a good choice at the end. I think that's good. Okay? You guys want to make good choices? Do it. All right. Well, that's always fun. I love doing that and seeing how God made chemicals to react with each other. So much fun. Now, I'm going to do an experiment that I have never done before. And you know how those can go. Maybe variations of it I've done. I guess you guys probably know what that stuff is. And so, now, as I said, I'm not sure what's going to happen here because I've never done this one before. I might have seen it done, but let's see. I'm going to pour that really dark purple stuff in here. Wow. Man. Let's see what we're going to put in next. Oh, yes, some of this stuff. Now, if all goes well, try that just like that. Are you ready? Here we go. What's going to happen? What's going to happen? Woo! Oh! Wow! You know what? I believe because of the way this works, we get a second chance to look at a couple of things right here. This is kind of cool, too. Look at the purple coming out of there. Isn't that amazing? Wow. Okay, let's see if we can just do a little bit more. I don't know. I see how it is. That's still coming out there, so I'm going to see if we can get any down in there and see what else happens. And it was fun, though. All right? That was great. Well, we have to finish things up. Kind of in the way we started things. Things. Might want to turn out the light for this, and for those of you that don't like loud voices, might be a good time to leave. Okay, we know if we put this up under the hood, it's going to make a loud noise, right?
Oops.
Oh, yeah, that was a loud noise. But if we put it under this balloon, I wonder if this same thing is going to happen.
Whoa.
Wow. That is fantastic. I love that. All right.
Thank you, Chief Science Officer James. Don't go anywhere. So, I know that many of you know that Chief Science Officer James is also Mr. Riddle.
Yeah.
And Mr. Riddle has been with us at VBS at least for 10 years.
Yeah. Oh, it's been a while.
But we are just so grateful to you and to our partnership that we have with you guys with you on today. And if anybody is looking for a wonderful Christian school, will you just give Mr. Riddle a call and
Absolutely.
We'll give you as much information that you need.
All right, been nice to be with you.
Thank you. All right, let me give you our green group solos. Where's our green group? All right. Green group. This is pretty impressive. Green group brought in $302. And 22 cents. Green Group 9, are any of Zoe's friends in Green Group 9 here this morning? Oh, we have some people up here. Now, Zoe, can you tell us, what was your favorite part of VBS this year?
I like Imagination Station.
Oh, our Imagination Station. Are any of our volunteers from Imagination Station here this morning? Yes, I see some hands up. Thank you so much for all of you guys for joining for this experience. Thank you for being here with us. And what is your name?
Julian.
And Julian, how did you participate in VBS this year?
I was an assistant.
All right, an assistant group leader. Our assistant group leaders are our junior high or our high school students, and we are so grateful that they are still a part of VBS in meaningful ways. And can you tell me a little bit about what you'll take away from VBS this year? What was meaningful for you this week?
Seeing the scene of the children in
our
group, seeing their smiles and having fun.
And what group are you in?
Red 14.
Are there any kids in Red 14 here this morning? I see one thing over there. Well, thank you so much. And your name? Maddie. And what area did you serve this year?
I went to games.
Games. Who had fun at games this week? Yeah. We want to say a special thank you to all of our games volunteers and Scott and Dwight Parker for leading that for us. And what was that experience like for you?
It was really cool to help all the kids because some didn't know it's new. And some were really passionate about winning, and it was just really cool.
Wonderful. Thank you so much for volunteering. Let's come this way so that people can see you. Yes, right in the middle. Yes. And can you tell everybody who you are?
Dory Taylor.
And Dory, how did you serve this week in VBS?
I was a group leader for Green 9.
Green 9. We have more Green 9 this morning. And can you tell us a little bit about your experience this week?
It was fabulous. I've gone to this church for 14 years, and for 13 of those years, we have not missed one single VBS. We have basically scheduled all of our family vacations around VBS because our kids would be so upset to miss it. And this is actually the first year I got to volunteer because I'm always more around with my own children, but my youngest was able to go with her big sister this year, which freed me up to be a group leader, and it was just such an amazing joy and experience to give back to the community. Over the years, so many people who are God-fearing, just amazing influences on my children, have mentored them through VBS, through Vacation Bible School, through Pathfinders, and almost teaching Sabbath School. And I just wanted to be able to give back in some way to our community and mentor other kids like people have for my daughters. So just seeing the excitement and the joy of the kids every night to be so happy about what they're going to learn about Jesus was just so joyful for me.
Thank you, Nora. Thank you so much. This Francis Jansen, and Francis has volunteered for a long time, and she has been a coordinator for our registration for many years, but this year we did something a little different. Tell us about that. Thank you so much. Alright. And what was your name?
Christian.
And Christian, what was your favorite part of VBS this week?
Snacks.
Snacks. We had a wonderful and fun snacks station this year. Are our snacks team here? Are they here this morning? Yes, I see hands up. And so many others, thank you so much for all that you've done. And what was one thing that you will remember from your kids?
That Jesus
rescues
women
and women. All right, thank you so much, Christian. And can you tell everybody your name? Noah. And what group are you with?
Yellow 17.
Anybody from Yellow 17 here this morning? I see. Mrs. Church was our group leader for Yellow 17, and what is one thing that you learned about Jesus, or was reminded about Jesus this week?
He rescues when you do wrong.
Yes, that is very important, that he does rescue when we do wrong. And what is something that was one of your favorite memories from this week?
Snacks.
Snacks, all right. As you can see, we enjoy our snacks. Thank you so much, Nana. And can you share with everyone here?
Megan.
And Megan, what group were you in?
Yellow 16.
Yellow 16! And her mom was her group leader this week. She was a group leader, right? Yes. All right, what was your favorite part of VBS this week?
Snacks and games.
Snacks and games. All right. And is there something that you'll take away from this week? Yes, when you are powerless, Jesus rescues. Thank you so much. As you can see, we have had a fun and meaningful week this week. And that is in no small part to all of our
Jesus rescues.
Before we take a look at our week in review,
안정될지 그 다음에 다시 빼버려야 돼요. 여기도 잡고 그러면 뭘 요잖아. 그러면 좀 흔들어도 괜찮아. 그러고 나서 드론으로 아주 찍어서 재밌게 잘 놀았네.
지난주에 271 families that will have clean water to drink for 6 months, which is amazing. Caleb and Kelsey here in concert right here in our sanctuary. Doors will open at 6:30, and if you're interested, you can find out more information in the courtyard as you get your frozen treats.
Isaac 아들인데 와서 일부러 저 인사를 하더라고. 그래서 찍는 거야. Chicago. Green, blue. So pretty.
Where's Ashley?
I'm just taking pictures. White one, maybe I write my name. Yeah, but black.
White one.
Yeah. It's a really good memory, you know.
Yeah.
Now is the time to worship. Just as you are to worship, come. Just as you are before your God, come. Everyone will bless your God. One day every knee will bow. Still the greatest treasure means for those who gladly choose you now. Come, now is the time to worship. Come. Children of the Lord.
are exhausted, but in the best possible way. And we've learned all week long about how Jesus rescues in so many different kinds of ways. And our theme song for this week is a song called Never Let Go of Me. And since I have so many of my friends already here, I want to ask you guys to stand up. And if there are any other kids from VBS who've attended this week, let's fill the way over here and over here. I'm not sure we should be standing on the steps, but come on down here on the floor. Some of you can be up top. Just be careful there. And we're going to do our theme song for you. And feel free to sing along as you are able. Here we go.
Thank you. And they're not going to be my friends anymore after this. But thank you to you ladies. And if you want to say something, you can. And that's the end of that friendship. Thank you, everybody.
I want to say a special thank you again to Maggie and Robbie and all the volunteers. I know that it takes a church family that's just amazing. This church, the VBS ministry has, isn't it amazing? Just amazing. Such amazing. And I also want to say a special thank you to Pastor Isaac and Pastor Vianna and also to And I want to give a little special shout out today to our sound person. Tyler. All that type of stuff, running it now. You did an outstanding job. Thank you, Tyler. We're blessed.
Come morning.
University School of Public Health, and they invite us to go on a retreat to the mountains of Yosemite. I had never been to Yosemite before, so I signed up immediately, and we were joining PUC in La Sierra. And so the tri-campus retreat was happening, and it was around March or April. And I went with my best friend, Priscilla, and we met two other physical therapy students there, Mohammed and Sahal. And the four of us became a tight little unit. The whole weekend we were having so much fun. But one day, they had us do a fun day, so they released us to go into town. And we could tour the museums, or go on little hikes, or sleep, or go back to camp, whatever we wanted to do. And we were so excited. So I haven't been able to do the Upper Falls, I just go to the Lower Falls, and so anyway, I think this year we're gonna try it. And I was like, Upper Falls, it sounds like it's worth going to. So we get up our van, we view the restroom, and the four of us just start wandering around. I said, what are we gonna do? And I said, let's do the Upper Falls hike. I hear it's a great hike. And everyone's like, okay, let's, you know, follow the signs. And we started on our hike. Now, I have no idea what I was getting into. I mean, when you think hike, I think hold the curves, right? Like, run on a walk. And so I want to show you what I looked like that day. I was carrying a big, fluffy jacket. This is what I had to carry my lunch, something like that, a big brown purse, and this is what I was also wearing. I was wearing these fashion boots that are made out of fabric, and if you still don't think that's pretty bad, check out what I had to work with. So Upper Falls is all about climbing rocks, right? If you guys have ever done this hike, it's a massive hike of rocks. But that's not the worst part. The worst part is between the four of us, I was the only one who brought water. And this is what I brought. I had 16 ounces for the four of us. We didn't think much of it because we were just going, you know, on a hike. And so the four of us started. Priscilla happened to be wearing rain boots. And it was a mental exercise, more so than physical. And let me tell you, these are some of the things that we saw. There was so beautiful. Yosemite became easily my favorite place in all of California, besides Cala Mesa. And so that's my friend Mohammed, and I mean, it was breathtaking. So we got up to the Upper Falls, and we were up there. You guys can see some of the falls, and we were dipping our feet in the icy water, and before we knew it, we realized that we had gone past our time to be back at the vans. They had told the students, be back around 5 or 6, we're going to drive back to Camp Pomona and have dinner. But, you know, we were going slow, since none of us were really fit for this hike. But we saw one of the van leaders go for us. So I was like, well, if we, you know, the van leader was ahead of us, we should be fine. We'll just go back down with him. And yet we were there, we were having so much fun, and we realized that the sun was starting to set. And we said, all right, well, it took us, I don't know, about 4 hours to get up. It'll probably take us 1 hour. We should be getting back in time. We had no idea about hikes. I mean, these guys were from Saudi Arabia. I mean, there's no Yosemite over there.
Up in San Diego.
So, between the four of us, we realized that we were not going to get down in time. Because I was wearing my slippery boots, I was slipping every 3 steps. So Mohammed told me, get a hold of my shoulder, and we just started wobbling down this mountain slowly because, friends, let me tell you, it was painful after the third fall. So, when nightfall came, Sahal pulled out his keychain. This is what he had. That's the only flashlight that we had between the four of us. Everybody's cell phone was dead except mine. It was around 30%, and I didn't want to use my flashlight in case we had an emergency. Not that I had any service up there, but we wanted to save it just in case. So we made our way down the mountain, and before we knew it, it was pitch dark, and I had heard all the horror stories of hikers getting lost and falling off cliffs and deaths everywhere and mountain lions and bears. And so I started praying, and it took us a while, but we finally got down. We met some hikers almost on our way to the end. They said, "You're on the right track, just stay on the trail." And I felt like kissing them. I was so happy to see people, to know that I was not lost. And I was praying that Jesus would come to my rescue. So we made it into the stream. We found our way into the lodge, and we had maybe sweat, blood, and tears caked with, you know, dust, and we looked like we had been in the mountains for years. But we made it back. I was rescued by Jesus. My boots were a disaster. The toes of my boots looked like this, and just fabric everywhere. And so as soon as we got back to Loma Linda, I hit up Aria, I want to show you. I finally got a pair of boots. So I'm going back to Yosemite this July. We're going to try to tackle that once again. Real boots this time and more water. But I don't want to just look at the evidence in my life of how Jesus has rescued me. We want to take you back to VBS, because during VBS week, we saw so many Bible stories of Jesus
rescuing.
And when we say Jesus rescues, we're going to do this, right? All right, let's try it one more time. Jesus
rescues.
All right, so I'm going to say it a couple more times, and every time I want you guys to listen carefully, and you're going to help me out. God was making these outrageous claims. He was saying things like, when you're lonely, when you worry, when you struggle, when you do wrong, when you feel powerless, Jesus
rescues.
And he said this all over the Bible. For example, the first story that we covered was about Martha. No, the parables. The parables of the lost coin and the lost sheep. Do you guys remember that? And this was our verse, and it said, "The Lord will hold me close." Psalm 27:10. And we saw that when you got lost, and you know, maybe have you ever been to a mall before, and you lose your parents? I've been there, and it is the most frightening thing on earth. You realize that you're never going to go back to your bed. You're never going to eat. You know, your mom's mac and cheese again. You're just frightened to death. And before you know it, they come back and grab you. So they rescue you. So we talked about being lost. And the promise was, the Lord will hold me close. So when you are lonely, Jesus rescues. Did he come through for them? He came through. All right, let's look at evidence number two. The second story. Martha worried about what? About getting stuff done. And I know this church is full of people who love to get stuff done. I mean, look at this place. It's amazing. If you guys go to our fellowship dinner right after here, you're going to see people full of getting, you know, people that get stuff done. So, he wants to let us know that, don't worry, friends. I've got you. We've got you. Don't worry. I've got you. So, when you worry, Jesus rescues. Thank you for that. Third story. Jesus' friends try to rescue him in Gethsemane. And Jesus was praying, and he was telling his disciples to pray, and he was sweating blood, and before you knew it, Judas came with all of the other people, and they came to arrest Jesus. And Peter was so angry, he drew out his sword, and he tried to chop off Jesus' ear, and Jesus was like, no, friends. No, I got you. Psalm 46:10 says, "Be still and know that I am God." So when you struggle, Jesus rescues. Yesterday we saw the story, Brittany acted it out, of Peter and John. And they were going to the temple, and they saw who at the ground? The crippled man, remember, and he was begging for money? And we saw in the story that they came and they had nothing. They had no money, they had no power, but they had the power of Jesus. So when they came upon this man, they said, "Silver and gold I do not have, but what I have I give to you. So in the name of Jesus Christ, rise up." And the crippled man that was no longer crippled stood up and he walked away. And we saw that when you are powerless, Jesus rescues. So we saw evidence all throughout the week that Jesus rescues us. But he wants to now make the invitation to you. He wants you to allow him to rescue you. So, 4 years ago, I'm going to put your feet to the fire. I'm going to put you to the test. I said, if you want me to come, Mesa, it's going to be because you want it. Because you're taking me out of this miry clay, this bottomless pit. You're taking me from my dungeons of despair. You're taking me from the bottom of the ocean. You're taking me to higher ground. And you're going to show me something fantastic. So he did. I don't have credentials behind my name that qualify me to be here. I told the last group, I don't even know what the third commandment is. So I said, I shouldn't be here. But if you want me here, I'll be here. I don't even have years of experience. I mean, children's ministry, I started that 2 years ago. Barely 2 years ago. God came to my rescue. And this week at VBS, I witnessed reasons why God has me here. First of all, I saw a church full of children. And that's been my dream come true, to have this church packed with children. Sorry, adults. Like, if you want to fit over there, that's fine. But this should be full of children. Balcony too. And I witnessed the volunteers coming together like I've never seen before. And I saw leadership rise where you would never expect it to. And before I knew it, this place was abuzz with love and energy and in and out and everything you can imagine. This was just a place of love and dedication. And I started feeling something bad. And I said, wait a second, VBS is my favorite time of the year. How come I'm feeling bad? This should be the happiest time of the year. Sorry, Christmas lovers. VBS is the best time of the year. And I asked God, what's going on? And God, in his grace, said, Viana, listen. You remember doing VBS in other places? And I'm like, yes. Remember what happened? I'm like, yes. You came through for us. And people would say this VBS was fantastic. And look at that setup. And you're doing great. And I would say, you see how the Lord provides. He, you know, you gotta trust him. And he brought us through this whole time. But the reality was that inside, I was saying like, yeah. Yeah, that was me. I didn't do that out loud. I did that. And it was a one-person show. Granted, I had volunteers coming in and out, but I had the ins and outs of this place. I had it from 0 to 100. I knew every detail that was happening. Not one hair would move without me knowing it, and it was fun. I was in control. And here I wasn't. I was helping people, and I was observing, and boy, did I learn. I was in for a big surprise. I had a huge learning curve. During VBS, I didn't have any nightmares, but I realized that this whole time, I had made it about me. VBS was about me, and at the end, I would just go home victorious, like, I am so good at VBS! And God was telling me, Viana, here at Cala Mesa, he was telling me, Viana, put it back in my hands where it belongs. It's not in your hands. It's not in Isaac's hands. It's not in Robbie's hands or Maggie's hands. It's in my hands. And you're going to be part of a family that comes together, part of a team. And you're going to come alongside me and help. This is not about you. So I learned to eat some humble pie. And VBS began to take new meaning. I want to show you a picture of Catherine Frickman and a couple friends. Emery happens to be in that picture. And when I saw this, I was reminded God is working in all of our volunteers. It was just such a tender moment. They were cuddling up next to Catherine. They were listening to Brittany and her team do a Bible story, and I saw Jesus coming through. And as I rotated through Claudette's, you know, singing station and the cruise and crafts and imagination station, I was blown away with what God was doing. And I had no part in that. And I was so happy. I was so happy that it was no longer in my hands. And it's still a learning experience. So, there is evidence that Jesus rescues. Friends, let me tell you, He is rescuing me. He has rescued us this week and He has promised something else. But, I want you guys to offer your imaginary goggles because we're going to go deep sea diving. So everybody grab your goggles, put them on. We're going to go deep sea diving. Hold your nose. And we're going to dive. We're going to go deep, 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 deep down into the last story of our VBS. And as we're sinking deeper and deeper, we're getting colder where the sun doesn't shine anymore. And over there are creatures that you've never seen before. It's a scary, dark place. And our last story happens to be where Jesus was at the cross. And next to Him was a person who had committed so many crimes. This person had no more time left. He had no more chances. There was nothing he could do to go back and forgive people. There was nothing he could do to go back and make things right again. He was shipwrecked, tied to a cross, and he reached out to Jesus and said, "Jesus, remember me. Take me with you." That was a perfect chance for Jesus to say, "All right, friend, well, what you gotta do is attend church every Sabbath and let go of your habits. And you know, and as soon as you get down off the cross, make sure you go to your brother and forgive him and that little girl you murdered. You gotta go ask, you know, forgiveness for the family and return the money that you stole." He had minutes left. There was nothing he could do to accept, to deserve God's grace, His love and His sacrifice. Nothing. And God said, "Hey, I will rescue you. I have rescued you and I will continue to rescue you. And when I come again for the second time, you're going to be there with me." So kids, we saw in that story the promise in John 16:33 that said, "I have said these things, so in me you may have peace. In this world you will have trouble, but take heart. I have overcome the world." And this promise was made before when they were having with his disciples in the Passover feast, right? And he made this promise before he died on the cross, before he told it to the criminal, before he came again for the second time. He had already promised us that he had overcome the world. So the promise that he made to us was, when you do wrong, what? Jesus rescues. One more time. When you do wrong, Jesus rescues.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Sorry.
Yeah. 진짜. 갑시다. 멋있다, 우리. 성경아.